today will be the continuation of our discussion, our lesson in Unit 1 of what I am using in our project, Easy Korean Reading. So, not to prolong our waiting, let us start where we stopped. Last time, our lesson was reading Unit 1, and then I gave you the vocabularies that are in the article or in the topic. So let's have just a short review, a quick review of the words, and then after that, we will be reading the sentences, the important sentences in it with the translation, okay? Alternate. So I will read the Korean sentence and the translation. Just a reminder, please, as you get along, as you listen to my reading, kindly try to write down what you understand so that you can repeat it after me, because I don't have yet I don't know how to flash it there. Maybe I will try it later, but my focus is just to practice reading, and you can also at the same time learn the words in Korean by listening to me, and then try to write down the sound that you hear, and then I will be giving the translation in the next part. So just consecutive in Korean and then English translation, Korean, English, Korean, English, that way. I don't know if you can read the Korean characters here like that. So maybe you can practice it with me later on. I will do a separate thing, just put a comment in my blog comment section what you want to do in order for you to learn easier. Maybe we can do it all together so that we will be successful in our goal of this project that we are doing. So come on, let's begin. Just a review of the words that we studied last time. Here are the words. It's quite a number, but you have to remember it quickly. Number one, 한국 사람들. 한국 사람들 means Korean people. 김치찌개, 김치찌개. Korean stew. 자주, 자주, often. 먹다, to eat. 돼지고기, pork. 도로가다, 도로가다, or 도로가다, to go in or to enter. 음식, 음식, food. 냄비, 냄비, pot. 벗다, 벗다, to fry. 익다, to be cooked. 넣다, to put in. Minute. 분, 분, 1분. 2분, so, minute, 정도, approximately, or around something, around, about, approximately. 고기, meat, 함께, together, 마지막으로, finally. 육수, meat, broth, or stock. 벗다, this one is 먹다, 먹다, and then 벗다. 벗다 is to pour. 더, more. 끓이다, to boil. 완성, complete or finished. 마늘, garlic. 대파, green onion. 토프, 맛있다, to be delicious. So these are the words in the reading that we had. Now let's go to the digesting of the reading. So the first sentence in what we read is 한국 사람들은 김치찌개를 자주 먹어요. I repeat, 한국 사람들은 김치찌개 자주 먹어요. It says Koreans or the Korean people, just Korean people often eat kimchi too. Second sentence in our reading practice. 김치찌개는 김치와 돼지고기가 들어가요. 김치찌개는 김치와 돼지고기 들어가요. There is kimchi and pork in kimchi stew. Number three, 먼저. 안녕하? What is 먼저? 먼저, the first. Okay, or in the beginning, at the start. 먼저 냄비에 돼지고기를 넣고 볶아요. First, put the pork into a pot and fry it. Next sentence. 그리고 돼지고기가 익으면 김치를 넣어요. 그리고 돼지고기가 익으면 김치를 넣어요. When the pork is cooked, add the kimchi. Next, 3분 정도 고기와 김치를 함께 볶아요. 3분 정도 고기와 김치를 함께 볶아요. Fry the pork and the kimchi together for approximately 3 minutes. Next sentence, 마지막으로 물이나 육수를 붓고 또 끓이면 완성이에요. Again, 마지막으로 물이나 육수를 붓고 또 끓이면 완성이에요. Finally, pour in some water or broth and boil it some more. Then it's done. Last sentence, 마늘, 대파, 두부를 넣으면 더 맛있어요. Again, 마늘, 대파, 두부를 넣으면 더 맛있어요. If you add garlic, scallions, and tofu, it's even tastier. So finish. Let's read it one more time. I'll listen to the one flow of the reading and try to understand it with all the vocabularies that were given. And then just practice later on what were the translations I have given. Just do it, rewind our video to learn all the sentences in English. So let's finish it. Let's wrap it up by reading for the last time the topic. Okay, 요리 or cooking. 시작. 한국 사람들은 김치찌개를 자주 먹어요. 김치찌개는 김치와 돼지고기가 들어가요. 먼저 냄비에 돼지고기를 넣고 볶아요. 그리고 돼지고기가 익으면 김치를 넣어요. 3분 정도 고기와 김치를 함께 볶아요. 마지막으로 물이나 육수를 붓고 또 끓이면 완성이에요. 마늘, 대파, 두부를 넣으면 더 맛있어요. Okay, so that's it. Thank you very much. And see you on our next topic, next meeting. Please don't forget, if you are new to my channel, please subscribe to Aaliyah once again. Thank you so much and see you soon. Bye!